हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 6 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 7 फ्रैक्शंस एंड दिस इज द समरी लेक्चर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल समराइज वॉट एवर वी हैव लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव लर्न द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ए फ्रैक्शन. व्हाट इज ए फ्रैक्शन? अ फ्रैक्शन इज ए नंबर विच रिप्रेजेंट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ ए होल. The whole may be a single object or a group of object. After that, we have learned how to make a fraction. The number such as 2 upon 3 and 7 upon 12 are called fractions. These are fractions, 2 upon 3 and 7 upon 12. And the number which is written above the division line is called the numerator of the fraction. And the number which is written below the division line is called the denominator of the fraction. Now in 2 upon 3, 2 is a numerator and 3 is a denominator. In 7 upon 12, 7 is a numerator and 12 is a denominator. Now our next topic is types of fractions. First is proper fraction. Proper fraction is a fraction whose numerator is greater than 0 but less than its denominator. It can't be 0. Numerator is can't be 0 but it is less than the denominator. Example, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 13, and there are many more examples. Second type of fraction is improper fraction. Improper fractions are those fractions whose numerator is greater than its denominator. Example of improper fractions are 9 upon 7 and 11 upon 5. See, in both these fractions, numerator is greater and the denominator is smaller. After that, next fraction is mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is a combination of two parts. One is a natural number and the other is a proper fraction. See the example, 4, 5 upon 9. Now 4, 5 upon 9, in this, 4 is a natural number and 5 is a proper fraction. That's why it is a mixed fraction. See, every mixed fraction can be written as improper fraction and every improper fraction can be written as mixed fraction. We can convert mixed fraction into improper and improper into mixed fraction. Next type of fraction is like fraction. Like fractions are those fractions whose denominators are same. Okay, example, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 2 upon 7. In all these fractions, denominator is 7. So these are like fraction. Next type of fraction is unlike fraction. Unlike fractions are those fractions whose denominators are different. Example, 3 upon 5, 1 upon 2, 7 upon 13. These all are unlike fractions. Next is equivalent fraction. What is equivalent fraction? Equivalent fractions have the same value. Example, 3 upon 5, 6 upon 10, 9 upon 15. How we can say that these three fractions are equivalent fraction? Now see, 3 upon 5 is a fraction, it is already in simplest term. But now say 6 upon 10, when we reduce it in simplest form, what we will do, we will cut it, we will cancel it by 2. Okay, so 2 threes are 6 and 2 fives are 10. So again, when we reduce it in simplest form, we will get 3 upon 5. Same is with 9 upon 15. When we reduce 9 upon 15 into simplest form, we will get 3 upon 5. So the value of all these three fractions is 3 upon 5. So we can say that these are equivalent fractions. Next is, the value of a fraction does not change if the numerator and denominator are multiplied or divided by the same number. Okay, so suppose one fraction is given to us, you are multiplying its denominator and numerator by any number. So its value does not change. That fraction can change, but it will be the equivalent fraction of previous fraction. In the same way, we can divide it also by the same number. Next point is, to check the equivalence of fraction, maybe two fractions are A upon B and C upon D. We are taking these two fractions. Use cross product rule. We will do cross multiplication to check the equivalence of the fraction. That means A multiplied by D must be equal to C multiplied by B. Okay, if they are equal, then the fractions are said to be equivalent, otherwise not. Next point is, a fraction is in irreducible or simplest form if its numerator and denominator have no common factor except one. If the numerator and denominator have no common factor, then they are said to be in simplest form. And I have told you earlier how to write down what are the methods to convert a fraction into simplest form. There are two methods. One is SCF method and other is factorization method. And normally we follow the factorization method. Now let us see how to compare two or more fractions. In the like fractions, the fractions with greater numerator is greater. Suppose we have two like fractions, we have to compare two fractions which are like. Okay, seeing the example 2 upon 5 and 4 upon 5. These two fractions are like fractions. Then whose numerator is greater, that fraction is greater. So 4 is greater than 2. So we can say that 4 upon 5 is greater than 2 upon 5. Next point is, in fractions with same numerator, the fraction with smaller denominator is greater. In the previous we have done when we have the same denominator. Now we are doing when we have same numerator. If we have the same numerator, the fraction with smaller denominator is greater. Okay, 4 upon 7 and 4 upon 11. Numerators are same. Now check the denominator. 7 is smaller than 11. So 4 upon 7 is greater than 4 upon 11. Because in this type of fraction, there is a opposite rule. Okay. Whose denominator is smaller, that fraction is greater. Whose denominator is greater, that fraction is smaller. Now let's move to general method of comparing fractions, means when we have the unlike fractions. Convert all the fractions into equivalent like fractions. This is the first step. Convert all the fractions into equivalent like fractions. They are unlike fractions, you have to convert them into equivalent like fractions. After that, then the fraction having same numerator is greater numerator is greater. When we get the like fractions, a fraction whose numerator is greater, that fraction is greater. Let us clear it with the help of example. Compare 4 upon 5 and 7 upon 9. Now see, in this question, neither numerators are same nor the denominator. These are totally unlike fractions. So we have to compare them by converting both the fractions into equivalent like fraction. And this we will do with the help of taking LCM of denominator. LCM of 5 and 9 is 45. Now convert first fraction 4 upon 5 with denominator 45. 5 9s are 45. We are multiplying denominator here by 5. So we will multiply numerator also by 9. 5 9s are 45, 4 9s are 36. This is the 36 upon 45 is the equivalent fraction of 4 upon 5. Now take the second fraction, that is 7 upon 9. Again, in this fraction also we have to make the denominator 45. So 9 will be multiplied by 5. So numerator also we will multiply it by 5. 7 5s are 35, 9 5s are 45. Our new equivalent fraction is 35 upon 45. Now 36 upon 45 and 35 upon 45. These are the equivalent like fractions. Okay, now they are like fractions. Compare them, which one is greater, whose numerator is greater. 36 is greater than 35. So 4 upon 5 is greater than 7 upon 9. Now see how to add and subtract two or more fractions. If you have like fractions, first of all I am taking the example of like fractions. If we have like fractions, then simply add or subtract the numerator and write the denominator once as it is. Okay, see the example. 2 upon 19 plus 7 upon 19 plus 3 upon 19. Denominators are same. These are like fractions. So add the numerator only. 2 plus 7 plus 3. We get 12. So it is 12 upon 19. Now see what procedure we will follow in case of unlike fractions. Suppose we have unlike fraction. First step is convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. If you have any mixed fraction, then first of all convert it into improper. Then second step is convert all the fraction into equivalent like fractions that we have done earlier also in case of comparison. Okay, convert them into equivalent like fractions. Then when you get the like fractions, then you have to add or subtract whatever the case may be. Okay, add and subtract and write down the common denominator. Okay, then last is convert the fraction into mixed fraction if it is an improper fraction. If you get the fraction as an improper fraction, then at last you have to convert it into mixed fraction. Now see the example of this also. And 5 1 upon 3 plus 4 upon 15. Now see, 5 1 upon 3 is a mixed fraction. So we have to convert first of all into improper one. 5 3 is a 15 plus 1 is 16. 16 upon 3 plus 4 upon 15. Okay, now the case is addition of unlike fraction. So we will make them equivalent like fraction by taking the LCM. LCM of 3 and 15 is 15. Take it as a common denominator 15. Now divide 15 by the denominator of the first fraction, that is 3. 3 5s are 15. Multiply 5, that 5, by 16. Numerator of the first fraction, 16 multiply by 5. Plus, now divide 15 by 15 is 1. Multiply 1 by 4. Okay? So 16 5s are 80, 4 1s are 4. So 80 plus 4 is 84, and write down common denominator ones, that is 15. It is 84 upon 15. This is a improper fraction. Convert into mixed fraction 5, 9 upon 15. We can again reduce it also. Simplest formula is 3 3s are 9, 3 5s are 15. So our fraction is 5, 3 upon 5. Now see students, as we have revised the summary of this chapter, I am giving you homework to do assignment of chapter 7. And this I have prepared it here only, okay? 8 questions I am giving to you. Do them in your practice notebook or any rough notebook and prepare from NCERT also, okay? Now let's take homework solutions of chapter 7, exercise 7.6, which I have given you in lecture number 7. I am not taking all the questions, few questions I am taking now. Question number 3, Nana was given 1 1/2 piece of cake, Najma was given 1/1/3 piece of cake. Find the total amount of cake given to both of them. It's a very simple question is this. Piece of cake given to Najma, 1/1/2, convert into improper fraction, 3/2. Piece of cake given to Najma, 1/1/3, 4/3. Total amount of cake given to both of them. Whenever we have to find out the total, we will add. So it is 3/2 plus 4/3. This is the case of addition of unlike fraction. So we will take the LCM. LCM is 6. Convert them into equivalent like fractions. It is 9 + 8/6. When you add, you will get 17/6. Convert into mixed fraction as it is a improper fraction. 2 5/6. So total cake given to both is 2 5/6. See the next question now. Question number 6. A piece of wire 7/8 meter long broke into two pieces. One piece was 1/4 meter long. How long is the other piece? Total length of wire is given to us, 7/8 meter. So we will write down total length of wire, 7/8 meter. Length of one piece is 1/4 meter. What is the length of the other piece? So length of other piece is subtract. 7/8 meter minus 1/4 meter. Again, denominators are different. So take the LCM. LCM of 8 and 4 is 8. Okay, divide denominator of first fraction by 8. 8 ones are 8. 1 multiplied by 7 is 7. Minus. Now divide common denominator 8 by the denominator of the first fraction, that is 4. So 8 divided by 4 is 2. 2 multiplied by 1 is 2. 7 minus 2 is 5. 5/8. So length of other piece is 5/8 meter. Now see question number 9. Jaydev takes 2 1/5 minutes to walk across the school ground, and Rahul takes 7/4 minutes to do the same. Who takes less time and by what fraction? Time taken by Jaydev to cross the school ground. How much time taken by Jaydev? It is 2 1/5 minutes. Convert into improper fraction. It is 11/5 minutes. Time taken by Rahul to cross the school ground, 7/4 minutes. Now compare 11/5 and 7/4. Whenever we have to do the comparison, we will convert both the fractions into equivalent like fractions. So we have to take the LCM. LCM of 5 and 4 is 20. Okay, 11/5. Denominator is 5. Make it 20. How we will make? By multiplying it by 4. So multiply numerator also by 4. It is 44/20. Same we will do with 7/4, second fraction also. And you will get 35/20. Now compare these two. 44/20 and 35/20. Which one is greater? 4/20 is greater than 35/20. So their original fraction is 11/5 is greater than 7/4. Now it is asked in the question, who took